Yeah, YouTube, and I have only once measured the Kirby G6 airflow from the nozzle, and I think that it is time to confirm those results. So I watched back that video what I did a long time ago when I got that airflow meter, and I spotted that it hit 124 CFM and not 121. So obviously bag is new and it is sealed to the airflow box very well. So is the Kirby still king of the airflow? Let's see about that. So let's see. Okay, I am pretty sure what this is going to do. Let's take it there so you can actually see that when it is performing. And this will scream this meter fan when we are measuring the Kirby. So let's go. Is the result, and let's calculate that what it is going to be in CFM. So yes, very high number, and yes, I know there is better performing vacuums, but all they are direct fan or dirty air vacuums, depending how you want to call it. So yes, and yes, you can see that conversion factor, and the result is that very high, so 126 CFM. So there is two reasons why I do this. Mainly because I want to do kind of benchmark test what my style of measuring does and how it shows the results. So for example, WACLAB bill below, if you are watching, I hope you are, what you got from your G6 and what I got from there. So we can see how that relates to my other airflow tests. So yes, very high number, 126 CFM. So yes, it is very high, extremely high in my book, because highest CFM bypass motor vacuum is my Vorwerk, and that got 100 CFM, what is unheard of any bypass vacuum. So Kirby still is the king in my collection. So let's see. So that was it, and this was confirmation video, so called, and my Kirby need a bit polishing. So, and my lightning is what it is. But I hope you saw this well. So yes, very very high, and oh man, I like this. Very very good vacuum, and special vacuum. Not the most practical for whole house cleaning, but for my rook, oh man, it is beast. So thanks for watching and goodbye.